How do we solve the area bounded by curves using integral calculus? The principle is this. If the boundary curves are top and bottom, from top to bottom, you move vertically. So your differential strip will be vertical. This is a very small change in x, so this will be dx. But this is a big change in y, so it will be y above minus y below. So that our differential area, which is the area of this differential strip, is going to be the area of the differential rectangle length times thickness. So it would be y above minus y below multiplied by dx. Now, in as much as this is dx, this must first be expressed in terms of x, then we integrate both sides. Integral of dA is a, so that the area is going to be equal to this. You just have to integrate this and set the limits. Okay? Now, if the boundary curves are right and left, from left to right, you move horizontally. So, this is a very small change in y, so this is dy, but this is not dx. It is a big change in x. So, it must be x of the right curve minus x of the left curve. So that the area of the differential strip or rectangle is dA, that is simply the length x of the right curve minus x of the left curve multiplied by the thickness dy. In as much as we are dealing here with dy, you express this in terms of y. Then you integrate integral of dA a. So the area is going to be the integral of x right minus x left in terms of y with the limits in terms of y. Let me illustrate it. Now we are asked here to find the area bounded by the curve x squared is y plus 4 and the x axis from x is minus 1 to x is equal to 2. So let me first plot the curve. Our curve is x squared equals y plus 4. Since this is linear and positive in y, our parabola opens towards positive y direction. Positive y direction is top up. Okay? So it is a parabola that opens up. And the vertex is at point, what point? Equate the x squared to 0, x squared to equal 0, so x is 0. This is the x coordinates of the vertex. Equate y plus 4 to 0, y plus 4 equals 0, y is negative 4. So this is a parabola that opens up and the vertex at 0, negative 4. 0, negative 4, x is 0, and 4 down, this one. So this is our vertex, which is 0, negative 4. And the parabola opens up. Now, we want here to find the area bounded by this curve, the x-axis. So let us plot our x-intercepts. At x-intercepts or x-axis, y is 0. When your y is equal to 0, your x squared equals 0 plus 4. So x squared is equal to 4. So x must be plus and minus square root of 4. This is plus and minus 2. So the x-intercepts are x equals 2 and x is minus 2. So your parabola must be this one. Okay? So this is your parabola. We want the area bounded by this parabola, the x-axis, from x equals minus 1. This is x equals minus 1, 1 unit left of the y-axis, to x is equal to 2. This is 2. That is, this is the line x is equal to 2. 2 units right of the y-axis. Okay? we want the area bounded by the parabola by the x-axis from here to here. So we want this area. So the two boundary curves are the x-axis and the parabola. Let me call the parabola as curve 1 and this x-axis as curve 2. So to cover this curve and this curve, they must be top and bottom. It cannot be left and right because if left and right, this will not be covered. So they are top and bottom. From top to bottom, it is vertical. So therefore, our differential strip must be vertical. You get it? So this is a very small change in x. This is dx. While this is change in y, it must be y above minus y below. So y above, the y on the x-axis is 0, minus y below, y of the parabola. Or this is going to be minus y parabola. You get it? So it's always y above minus y below. X right minus x left. Okay? So defining our differential area, the area of our differential strip, this one, the area of differential rectangle is length times thickness. So the length is minus y of parabola multiplied by the thickness. The thickness is dx. So in as much as we are dealing with dx, this must be expressed in terms of x. But the y of parabola, take note from this equation, this is the equation of the parabola. The y of the parabola, when expressed in terms of x, y is x squared minus 4. So you substitute that here, your dA is going to be equal to minus of x squared minus 4. This is the y of the parabola. You get it? So multiplied by dx. Everything here is in terms of x. We are ready to integrate. Integrating both sides, integral of dA is a, right? So we now just set the limits. This is dx, everything must be x, including the limits. Our limits must be x leftmost to x rightmost. The leftmost of this area is here, minus 1. The rightmost of this area required is here, that is 2. So this is x equals 2. So therefore, the area is going to be, integrate this using your calculator and you will get, and this area, once you calculate, is equal to 9 square units. Okay? Do you follow? Okay? What if we are required to find the area between x is negative 1 to x equals 3? X equals 3 is here. 3 units right of the y-axis. So the boundary curves are the parabola and the x-axis. Now, we cannot just solve it using this definition from negative 1 to 3. Why? Look here. Look at the position of the area. This one, the x-axis is above the parabola. But here, the x-axis is below the parabola. The parabola is on top, the x-axis is at the bottom. Look here. If I'm going to get a vertical differential strip here, this is dx, while this must be y above minus y below. The y above is the parabola, y of the parabola, minus the y below. The below is the x-axis, y is 0. So this is positive y of the parabola. You get it? The differential area of this, dA, is going to be equal to y of the parabola, the thickness yp minus 1 times the thickness dx. It is different from this one. This one is negative y parabola times dx. This one is y parabola times dx. You get it? So it means this area and this area must be solved differently. Although in your calculator, you will just have to remove the minus sign here and set another limits, then you'll be able to get this. Let me call this dA2. This is dA1, so this one is A1. Your dA2, therefore, is going to be equal to positive yp. Yp is x squared minus 4. So that when we integrate, we will get A2. And this is dx. Our limits for x2, x leftmost to x rightmost, the leftmost for this is 2, the rightmost is x is 3. This must be 2 to 3. So solving your A2 is going to be, on your calculator, 7 over 3. So therefore, our area total, the total area from here to here bounded by the parabola and the x-axis is going to be this area, which is area 1, plus this area, which is area 2. So area 1 is 9, area 2 is 7 over 3. So you add this, this is going to be equal to 34 over 3 square units. Do you get it?